Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Apollo Justice. We're in the Right Anything Agency. And oh boy, is this case getting interesting. Huh? Yeah, seriously, out with it.
That was weird.
Huh? Yeah, seriously, this case is confusing as heck. Yeah, seriously. All right, how about we talk to her for a bit? No. Yeah. Interpol, International Police. They do. It's shortened, Interpol. Fuck are you? Uncle Valart? Valant? Then why'd you call him Uncle?
As seen on TV. Huh? Wow. Huh. Oh. Well, that's a thing. Nope. That's too many L's in one sentence. Holy crap! Shit! Huh. Guarantee that's her father. Oh, well, that's good to know. Tape. Yeah, sure, let's watch it. Thank you. I don't know if any of you all saw it, but if you looked at one point in the guitar, you could actually see a flash at the inside of it. Let's present this tape. Really? Yeah, that is true. Yeah, seriously. Well, those are questions for another time. For now, I think we should try and move to the detention center. Interesting. Well, now we should move back to the Colosseum. Because we've got a lot of stuff to do. And a short time to do it. Yeah, seriously. Oh, gosh. Alright, so we moved here. Let's go to the backstage hall. And finally, the piece of evidence that I've been wanting to pick up forever now is finally available to be picked up. Let's talk to her, shall we?
The voice.
Sounds like a villain from a game or a movie. Or it could be a good guy. I've heard of good guys being called the voice. Tell us about Machi. Yep. Tell us about this darkness. My ear itches. Hold on. Itchy ear. Huh. Well, here's the thing. Even if it was someone who did something horrible, the fact that she can't remember it, or she says she can't remember it, if that's true, would actually... Yeah, that would actually throw suspicion off her trail, because she'd be a different person, basically. Yeah, seriously. No. No, you cannot. Oh, gosh. That's freaking hilarious. Alright, so now we gotta move to the stage. I love the music that's playing right here. And there he is. Huh. I can't figure out who the murderer is really in this one. Also, I just noticed he's got diamonds and hearts, and I think Trudy has clubs and spades. It's true. There used to be like a whole bunch of magicians on TV and all that. Like, I was around back when the Masked Magician was a thing, if any of you all remember that. Tell us about you and your partner. Yeah. Oh, she's got clubs and diamonds on. Oh, she's got hearts too and diamonds. Never mind. Huh? I thought she only had two. All right. So let's examine this freaking piano, shall we? What? A switch. Well, I think we're going to go to the next room, and then I'll call it an episode for now. And move into the mirror's dressing room. All right, well... That's weird. That's weird. Okay, let's go back to the stage for a second. Something's up. I talked to him about everything. Yeah. Okay. So I can't figure out what's going on right now because it's telling me where to go. Are we going to present it to him? Let me try going back to where I was supposed to go to. It says go to... Yeah, it says go here. I see what I missed. And in fact, I'll do this, then we'll end. Alright, so now we... Do we talk to her about it? No. Okay, so now we move into here. That was what I was missing. Yeah, here we go. Little details. And we all know who that is! When did she start taking up snacks? Well, we'll find that out, what she found strange, in the next episode. Anyways, this has been Mr. KotorX. And remember, folks, there's no point being an adult if you can't act childish from time to time, and I'll see you all in the next video. Also, I learned how to save. So, anyways, I'll see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.